Hand sanitizers are really handy, especially when soap and running water aren't within reach. But are they worth using more often, or should you try and avoid them altogether? Hand sanitizers contain ingredients like alcohol, which is often at 70% concentration, that works to kill microbes. When left on the skin for 30 seconds or longer, it's able to kill 99.9% of bacteria present, and even certain types of viruses like influenza A. The sanitizer breaks open the cell membranes of these bacteria, or the envelopes of viruses, although they're ineffective against spore-releasing bacteria and viruses without envelopes. There are also non-alcohol-based sanitizers using other ingredients, but depending on their combination, may just be bacteriostatic, meaning they prevent bacterial reproduction. Of course, anyone who's used sanitizer knows that it simply spreads grime and dirt around, so soap and water are necessary in these cases to clean up. But in the absence of visible dirt, which works better? A 2009 Australian study had vaccinated hospital workers contaminate their hands with live influenza A virus and had some of them wash their hands with regular soap and water for 40 seconds, followed by paper towel drying, while some rubbed their hands with 61.5% ethanol sanitizer for 20 seconds, and others used a combination of alcohol and antibacterials. The remaining group was the control and did nothing. As expected, the control group had the most viral DNA present, but the group with the least viral DNA was the soap and water group. Despite the fact that sanitizer can destroy germs, soap and water actually removes them from the hands and comes out as the superior method of infection control. But does the temperature of the water matter? Turns out that while hot water can kill bacteria, this only happens at 99.98 degrees Celsius, which would burn your skin. So save some energy and wash with cold water. Of course, soap can also be antibacterial, and these often contain triclosan, so is that even more effective? Well, it turns out that they're typically way below the effective 1% concentration required to cause bactericidal effects, and studies from around the world have shown these soaps to be no better than regular soaps. Furthermore, triclosan is washed down the drain and ends up in lakes and rivers. In fact, it's one of the top 10 contaminants found in all American rivers, bioaccumulating in many marine organisms like dolphins. Even more troubling is that triclosan has been linked to promoting antibiotic resistance in bacteria. In a process called cross-resistance, as bacteria become resistant to triclosan, they simultaneously evolve to resist the effects of other antibiotics, even though they haven't been exposed to them. While this doesn't mean using antibacterial soap will render your antibiotics ineffective, the study highlights the possibility of unnecessary antibacterial usage potentially leading to superbugs. Of course, a common misconception is that hand sanitizer causes bacterial resistance as well, which in most cases it doesn't, as they primarily use alcohol as their active ingredient. But some brands of hand sanitizer do include antibacterial ingredients like triclosan, so it's important to be aware. At the end of the day, your best bet is always using regular soap and washing with cold water, saving sanitizer for sink-less situations, and avoiding antibacterial soaps for the sake of your health, the environment, and future generations. But is it truly better to be clean in the first place? We debate between being clean or dirty in our new ASAP Thought video that you can click here, and look at the hygiene hypothesis and other studies to figure out the best way to live your life from a sanitary perspective. Don't forget to subscribe for more weekly science videos every Thursday. We'll see you next week.